Good morning, YouTube. This is the isolated variable AC power supply put together a little over a year ago, and I added this AC panel meter, and I did a couple videos on those. And overall, I've been pretty happy with this setup. There's a couple of things, though, that I'd like to fix. One is right here. There's a residual current and power reading, and those vary with the voltage. If I go up to around 120 volts, yeah, the power jumps up to like 6/10 of a watt. You've got about 40 milliamps current. And as you go down, then the current drops to 30, and the power drops to 0.4 watts. And then the other problem is, if you keep going down in voltage, that happens. It freezes up around 60 volts, and then at some point it shuts off. There's actually two different causes of those problems. So one of the problems, not really a problem, it's just this particular meter uses a current transformer, and I chose that because I put the current transformer inside the power supply here, and I just ran the wire that goes to this built-in ammeter through the current transformer, and that way I'm able to sense the current without having to modify any of the wiring inside the power supply. However, that current transformer is rated for up to 100 amps, and we're trying to read down to 10 milliamps, so that's like a 10,000 to 1 range. And so this least significant digit here is pretty much noise. You know, it's not going to read very accurately, and then that reflects into the power. I imagine this current transformer is just picking up stray magnetic fields inside of this, and this particular power supply has got a big variac on this side and then a big isolation transformer on this side, so there's a lot of magnetic fields running around, and that's what that current transformer is sensing. The other problem is this meter runs off of the voltage that it's measuring, and it's only rated down to 80 volts. It seems to work down to about 60. There's two different fixes. So one is I'm going to swap this meter, which is the PZEM-061, which is the 100 amp with the current transformer. I'm going to swap it out for one of these meters, which is the, if you can see that there, it's the PZEM-021, which is a 0 to 20 amp meter. And it has a built-in current shunt instead of the current transformer. So I'm hoping that by using a lower range meter, 20 amps is more than enough because this power supply only puts out 7 amps maximum. So a 20 amp meter will be a lot more in range. And I'm hoping with the current shunt, which is just a low value resistor, that this least significant digit here will be a lot more accurate. And then the other thing I want to do is inside of this meter, I want to repower the meter by adding a wire off of this input capacitor, which is the capacitive dropper power supply for this device. So I want to take that input power and run it from a separate non-variable voltage. So I'm going to be adding a fifth wire over here. So it'll have the four sense wires, voltage sense, the current sense on the outside, and then there'll be a fifth wire that will actually power this unit. I will show you that in a bit. I've got to get this taken down off my bench, open it up, and then see if I can find the best place to cut this wire, because I'm going to have to cut and tap into the wire running to the ammeter, which feeds the two outlets, and then I've got to find a good place to get the 120 volt constant voltage out, and then get this meter out of here, and then I'll have to get this meter modified, and so I'll show you how to modify this meter to give it an external power supply, so to speak, and then we'll see if we can get that put back in here. And I don't want to modify this meter until I see what's inside of this power supply, because I need to figure out how long of a wire to add on here, because I'd rather just come right out of here, have a wire that's long enough to run inside the here. Next step, we'll shut this down, get it off the bench, and take a look inside there again and see what we're looking at. So we'll catch you later.